If I could pick a smartphone as the best affordable smartphone of 2016, I would probably nominate the Honor 8. The Honor 8 Pro is now the latest model, coming with a huge display and great specs for a low price. I recently got the Huawei P10 and I liked it because of the small form factor, the good performance and the dual camera setup. So I was really surprised when I noticed that the Honor 8 Pro is 50 euros cheaper but comes with a 5.7-inch 2K screen, the same Kirin 960 chipset, 6GB of RAM instead of 4GB, and also dual camera setup. The screen is just beautiful with its Quad HD 1440p display, which results in 515 ppi, making it also good for virtual reality. Inside of the box you will find a 18W Huawei quick charger and a USB Type-C charging cable. Due to its high res display, they also include a cardboard in the box to experience virtual reality with the Honor 8 Pro. The body reminds me a bit of the iPhone 7 Plus, because the form factor is almost the same and also it's a little bit thinner, which makes it pretty good. I got the navy blue version, which looks at the first look also a little bit like a Galaxy Note 7 from the color. On top we have a 8MP front facing camera, which is this time not like a branded, but offers a good 84 degrees wide angle field of view. Also in the good sounding earpiece we have a multicolor notification LED, which I really like. At the top of the frame there's also a secondary microphone and an IR blaster to use the smartphone as a remote control for your TV or other devices. And at the bottom there is a mono speaker, which sounds not too bad. Even though it's slimmer than the iPhone 7 Plus, it still features a 3.5mm headphone jack, which I think is pretty good. The buttons are also made out of metal and they are placed on the right side of the frame, and on the opposite side there's a dual SIM slot. If you have a closer look at the backside, then you can see the dual cameras, which look a bit like in the P10, but they are also not Leica branded, and the phone has a 12MP sensor instead of 20MP. They are supported by a dual tone LED flash right next to it and a fingerprint scanner that can also be used as a shutter button. The fingerprint scanner is really fast and accurate and unlocks the phone from the sleep state without a problem. But the feature to use it as a programmable button is not included right now. So the only bad thing right now is that it's not water resistant. The phone comes with a 4000mAh battery that can be charged from 0 to 100 in less than 2 hours. But I noticed that the phone gets quite warm while using it and charging it. There is no overheat, but it felt too warm for me. Well, that's what you have to deal with when you put such a big battery in such a thin smartphone. The battery life is good, they said 2 days normal use. Well, for me it's like a full day of heavy use with a lot of screen on time and also GPS. So I think 2 days of normal use for users could be true. The phone runs Huawei's Emotion UI 5.1 on top of Android 7. The amount of bloat got a bit reduced, but still some system apps are there like Vmall, TripAdvisor, Booking.com and some more games. It's nothing to worry about since you can easily uninstall them. The UI is very fast and the Kirin 960 with 6GB of RAM makes multitasking very comfortable and smooth. The only thing that annoys me is that some of the apps have issues and also that I always need to open the Facebook camera twice to get it to work. So Wi-Fi seems to be quite good and the phone comes also with NFC support. Talking about the camera, well, it's not that good like in the P10, but still quite nice for the price. It also got an RGB and a monochrome sensor, but here both are 12MP. It works pretty much the same like in the P series, so two sensors equals more light, and with the software they can combine both information and get better contrast and punch. However, it got two f/2.2 lenses, which are not Leica branded, but features the same software features like the P10. There's also this wide aperture effect for impressive bokeh, which is sometimes, well, a bit too much and not really natural, but a real cool feature to get DSLR-like pictures with some software magic. So the overall image quality isn't that good like in the P10, but I think it's still quite good and also in low light. The 8MP front-facing camera wasn't that impressive and gets quite noisy in low light, so if you're a selfie fan, you should definitely check out the P10, which has a Leica-branded front-facing camera with also auto wide-angle mode. The phone is also capable of 4K recording at 30fps and 1080p on the front-facing camera. A in-depth camera comparison comes soon. So guys, this is a quick 4K recording test. We're here in Berlin, near the dome, as you can see. And yeah, 4K looks really beautiful. The contrast, the dynamic range, but It looks a little bit shaky right now on the screen, but well, just check it out right now on the computer, and as you can see, those nice bubbles right over here, so it captures a lot of details. Over here, the tower, everything looks pretty fine. Now this is a quick video test with 1080p, and this is now with the stabilizer turned on, so it has software stabilization, and I'm currently walking, so as you can see, the software stabilization makes the picture really smooth. So in 4K it looked kinda shaky, but here in full HD with software stabilization turned on, it looks actually quite smooth. But this stabilization only works in 1080p, 720p, but not in 4K.
DPS performance is also great, and it even finds a fix indoor very fast. Regarding gaming, it performs pretty much like the P10, so I can't notice a difference with the 6GB of RAM, and also multitasking is super fast, so I think that 6GB of RAM is more than you will ever need.